introduce my topic for today, which is Waste to Wealth, Eco-Catalyst for Biodiesel Production. So, I believe that everybody here has taken a flight before, at least a domestic flight, right? So, things that may come to your mind when I talk about flight is, what is the latest promotion in town? Or is AirAsia giving out free tickets today? Well, thing that I want you to know is that I'm not giving any free tickets today, right? So, moving on, this is an image taken from inside of an aircraft. Reason is, you can see the wing of an aircraft here, right? Now, the red focus here is the view that you get out of the windscreen. The beautiful green image is really unique only in Malaysia, no matter taking off or landing into Malaysian grounds. This is the image that a foreigner would see first when he lands into Malaysian grounds, right? So, any guesses what I'm talking about here? Well, to those of you who are guessing oil palm, congratulations. That's exactly what I'm talking about, right? So, oil palm is crop grown in Malaysia, and as we know, Malaysia is the largest palm oil and palm oil based product supplier in the world, yes? And there are more than 5.74 million hectares of land planted with oil palm, and these are statistics from last year, and I believe that these statistics have increased this year. So, the little we know that only 10% of this huge plant contributes to palm oil production, and think about what happens to the other 90%. Or even how does it even look like? Now, this is how the other 90% looks like, right? It's not something pretty to look at compared to the green and beautiful plantation image, right? So, my focus here is about the palm oil empty fruit bunches specifically. And the empty fruit bunches are the bunch that is left behind after the palm fruits have been harvested. And statistics states that they are over 7.31 million tons of EFB produced from 434 oil palm processing mills every year in Malaysia, right? Can you imagine how huge is that amount? And think about what happens to dispose it. What do we do to dispose all this waste? It is a waste product, right? Sadly, what was traditionally done is just by openly burning it to dispose it, right? Can you imagine burning 7.31 million tons of EFB every year in Malaysia? And can you imagine how much of pollution that is going to cost? It's a huge, huge amount of air pollution, right? A really huge amount of air pollution. And the good thing is that this practice has come to a stop due to the amount of air pollution. And instead, EFB is then just left to mulch in the fields, right? So this, on the other hand, is causing further problems. What is the problem? Soil pollution due to the excessive amount of one particular type of nutrient. Well, a soil is known to be fertile when it has a balanced various types of nutrients, right? Now, if you think that I've said things that are bad enough, these are further ways how EFB is contributing to air pollution. EFB are co-fired in a boiler in coal power plants in Malaysia in order to produce electricity. If you talk to officials, they say, oh, it's all good, it's no harm caused to the people, because the pollutants from the coal power plants are moving into the atmosphere and it's deposited into the ocean when it rains. And we think, oh yeah, it's all good, but that's where you're wrong, right? This causes further serious acid rain, right? Acid rain is a really alarming problem and most of us take it really lightly. But the thing here is, this image shows us how acid rain affects our lives as human beings. As you can see, that smoke from the coal power plants that are being moving into the environment, and they move with the clouds, and it hits us back when it rains, right? Not only that it hits us back, it also harms the sea creatures when it rains into the ocean. Now, these are before and after images of stone sculptures that are damaged by acid rain corrosion over the years. And if acid rain can corrode stone, human skin is nothing. Hence the outbreak of various skin diseases and skin cancer. Right? And these are images of sea creatures that are dead and harmed due to polluted water. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm not here to propose a new idea of a green and source of energy without causing pollution. All I'm saying is, why use EFB to contribute to an application that contributes to pollution? How about using EFB for another better purpose that has zero amount of pollution? Now, leaving pollution behind, let's talk about biodiesel. When Right, what comes to your mind when I say biodiesel? Some may ask me, has it got anything to do with biology? Or do we even see ourselves using biodiesel in the near future? All I can say is biodiesel is safe, biodegradable, and produces way lesser pollutants when combusted compared to petroleum-based diesel, right? So how is biodiesel produced? It's simple. We have oil and alcohol that are mixed together in the presence of an acid and base catalyst. It's that simple. Scientifically, we call these two processes esterification and transesterification, and the product of these two processes are called biodiesel, right? So, now I'd like to bring all of you here today, back in time to your childhood, to play a little game with me. Does that sound interesting? And that game is called Spot the Difference. Literally, spot the difference between these two conical flasks. If you manage to spot the difference between both these conical flasks, congratulations, you have just found out the problem faced in the biodiesel industry today. As I mentioned earlier, I told you catalysts need to be present in order to produce biodiesel. And traditionally, the catalyst used is a liquid state of matter. Now, the million-dollar question is, how are we going to separate the catalyst out of the biodiesel when the reaction is completed? Because the last thing we want is catalyst contamination in our biodiesel, right? Think about it. So, all that I've told you until now is all problems, problems, and more problems. So, let's recap on the issues that we face today, which are, first up, waste management issues, and next, pollution issues, and next, catalyst separation issues from biodiesel. Now, what are we going to do to address all these problems? Ooh, what's this? It's waste biomass to solve catalyst separation issues while arresting pollution? Whoa, that's fantastic. Is this thing even for real? If it is real, it can solve all three of our problems today simultaneously. And how is that even possible? The good thing is, yes, it is possible. How is it possible? Through waste to wealth, eco-catalyst for biodiesel production, and hence that's my topic for today, right? So, I will be using my waste EFBA to produce an eco-catalyst for biodiesel production. And ladies and gentlemen, wealth here denotes wealth not for us as human, as what you may think. It's wealth for our beloved planet Earth. Now, talking about eco-catalyst, what is catalyst anyway? Let us use this image to help us understand. You see this guy here pushing a load, a wheelbarrow full of load with lots of difficulty, and that's an example without a catalyst. And you see this guy below who is just sweeping the load with ease across the mountain, right? And that's an example of a catalyst application, because catalyst is said to increase the rate of reaction without itself being consumed. So it is easier for a reaction to occur, and the results are amazing. This is a cake, as everyone knows. Everyone here has eaten a cake before, but I'm not sure if everyone has baked a cake before. Off the records, you should learn how to bake sometime. Trust me, it helps in impressing your loved one. Trust me, it works. Right? Anyway, to those who have baked before, this is not something unfamiliar, right? Baking powder is a must ingredient in cake baking, where it helps the cake to rise, become spongy and fluffy while it's baked in the oven. And baking powder is a real-life example of a catalyst. Okay. Now, I mentioned that I'll be using my EFB to synthesize my eco-catalyst. And have you wondered why biomass fibers? And why precisely EFB for catalyst? The answer lies here. This is an SEM image of my EFB under a scanning electron microscope. And notice the ring-like shapes here are porous, right? EFB is very, very porous. And another material that I use for eco-catalyst synthesis is knef core fibers. Reason is simple. Notice the huge lumens that are in the middle of the fiber, and they are also pores on the surface area, right? And how does it even work? How am I going to use my fibers to make eco-catalyst? Right, we should use this small animation to help us understand. This cube here, the center represents biomass fiber, and the blue particles represent the catalyst chemical particles involved. So what is going to happen is the catalyst chemical particles are going to mix with the fiber. And once it is mixed, what is going to happen is the chemical particles are going to be loaded into the pores of the fiber. Right? And once that happens, this is my eco-catalyst, and it's in a solid state of matter. And this helps us to separate the catalyst out of the biodiesel because it's in a solid state of matter, no more liquid. So, from oil palm EFB waste, I've successfully produced AFB-supported iron oxide catalyst for biodiesel production, and the SEM image of it shows you clearly that the chemical particles are loaded into the pores in a cluster in a mushroom-like shape, right? And from Knef core fibers, I've successfully produced Knef-supported tungsten oxide particles, which are yellowish-green in color. The sample of catalyst are in the display box. And the SEM image shows us that tungsten oxide particles in a needle-like shape are loaded into the pores of Knef core fibers. So, how does this even work? How does eco-catalyst work in biodiesel production? So, let's take a look. We have the eco-catalytic system for biodiesel production, and we see that oil and alcohol, which is methanol here, is channeled into the reactor vessel through the pump, right? And it flows through the eco-catalytic tank. So, what happens inside of the eco-catalytic tank? Let's take a closer look. So, this is the newly designed eco-catalytic tank, where the fluids, which are oil and alcohol, flows through the eco-catalytic tank, and the eco-catalyst itself does not leave the tank. So, this is a unique design that is designed by me to utilize the eco-catalyst, right? So, what are the advantages of my eco-catalyst? It is reusable, right? Since it's in a solid state of matter. Since it's reusable, it is a huge cost saver. Next, it is green and biodegradable, and hence produces zero amount of pollution. It has simple catalyst separation method through simple filtration will do, right? So, there's no need for a tedious and expensive chemical separation method of catalyst. It converts abundant local biomass into a valuable product. So, I've converted the waste AFB into a solid catalyst for biodiesel production, hence arresting pollution. Creates public awareness on the utilization of biomass and waste material. Small hands change the world. Well, my idea of an eco-catalyst is a small effort to arrest pollution. So, I urge everyone to do the little you can for our planet Earth before it's too late. Not for us, but for our future generations. So, I want you all to take a minute to think and do as much as possible to save planet Earth before it's too late, right? So, a wise philosopher once said, the greatest wealth is health. But I leave you all today by saying, a wealthy world makes a healthy man. Hence, waste wealth, not for mankind, but wealth for planet Earth. Thank you very much for